Hi Oppo Stars, hi guys. Now I'm with another live video again, and today I'm going to have chosen a North Indian sabji which we can make via this Oppo's method. The sabji which I have chosen is Dhaba style mughalai mutter paneer. So I'm going to show you guys how to do it in this Oppo's method. It is a very quick and easy and tasty recipe. You just have to cut onions and tomatoes. Otherwise, there's nothing, no other preparation for this recipe. Just a spice paste, and you can use frozen paneer and frozen peas for this recipe. Let's move on to the recipe now. I've taken my magic pot. First I'll show you the recipe and then I'll move on with how to go about it. So this is the recipe. I hope it's clear. So after this I'll post the screenshot of the recipe below the video so you can actually note it down. Now you can take a screenshot of this recipe. So you should take a 2 liter pressure cooker, layer 1 butter and water. Layer 2 onions and tomatoes chopped. I'm going to arrange it in half and half so both of them gets equal caramelization. Layer 3 spice powders, and along with that I'm adding 2 tablespoon cashew powder that gives the richness for the sabji. And I'm going to take a small 2 small cups with half cup peas and paneer each. I'm going to keep it above the onions and tomatoes. And then you cook on high for 4 whistles. I'm having it for 4 whistles because I want the onions and tomatoes to be caramelized. Then we release pressure immediately. Then we are going to remove the cup, blend it with 1 teaspoon of honey, then add back the peas and butter, and then our sabji is ready. So what are the spices I'm going to use in this recipe? The spices I've used or I'm going to use is 1 teaspoon ginger garlic paste, 3/4 teaspoon coriander powder and cumin powder, half teaspoon each salt, red chili powder and garam masala, 1/4 teaspoon each turmeric powder and black pepper powder, and 1 green chili. So I guess we'll move on with the recipe. I'm ready with all the ingredients here. Let's go. So for saving time, I have actually taken all the spice powders ready like this, so it's easier. You don't have to go and run behind each and every canister in your house and then take each and every spice powder. Have it ready always so that you can finish your cooking on time. So, okay, I have my magic pot ready. I'm going to add the first I'll add everything and then I'll explain about the recipe and I'll tell you details. So now I've arranged everything. These are the layers needed for this recipe. So I'm going to start my stopwatch now so to see how long it takes for the sabji to cook. I've used frozen paneer and frozen peas directly from the freezer. You don't have to defrost in this recipe. So I've standardized my cooker at 1100 and I'm starting my stopwatch. So there has to be 4 whistles or 5 minutes, whichever, 4 whistles or 5 minutes, whichever is earlier. So again, I would like to show you guys the recipe now. Please note it down. So you have to have a 2 liter PC. So you add 2 tablespoon butter. So other option is you can add ghee or even any other oil, but when you use butter you have the special richness in the taste of the sabji. So 1 tablespoon water. So whenever I'm using onions here, I want it to be caramelized. I don't use more than 1 tablespoon of water here so that it stops the caramelization. And don't get scared because I'm not adding much water, because the water from the tomatoes will make sure that it doesn't burn and the sabji has enough water. And I always arrange it half and half so that both of them get equal caramelization. And this is the layer 3, the spice powders which I showed you guys. And I had a cashew powder as a staple ready with me, 2 tablespoons, and I've added that. So I've taken 2 small vessels with half cup and frozen peas and half cup frozen paneer. And I'm going to cook it on high for 4 whistles or 5 minutes, whichever is earlier. Again, there were a lot of people who asked me that whenever they try cooking paneer, it becomes hard after 2 or 3 whistles. And here I've used Amul frozen paneer, malai paneer. I have not faced any such problems with this brand of paneer, so you guys can try that. Or you can also choose to add the paneer after you cook the sabji. And here is a spice powder. So I've used Opus ginger garlic paste and other coriander powder and cumin powder and salt. And instead of red chili powder, I've used degi mirch powder for the special color. Since I'm using 1 green chili and pepper powder, I'm using degi mirch powder. The spiciness, the degi mirch powder is not as spicy as a normal red chili powder. So this is the mughalai mutter paneer template. And generally this is a sabji template which I follow. So I thought I'll let you guys know what kind of a sabji template I follow. So basically for layer 1 I use oil or butter or ghee, and I add 1 tablespoon water, because most of my sabjis I want caramelization of onions and tomatoes. And layer 2 I add onions and tomatoes. Layer 3 the spice powders, whatever we want. So there might be some sabjis where you might just want to have a very simple garam masala and salt. So you can add the spice powders according to your wish. And layer 4 you can add any vegetables of your choice. So you can choose to cook on high for 2 whistles or 5 minutes or 4 whistles, depending on how caramelized you want the sabji to be. When you actually cook, when you have vegetables, when you cook for a more number of whistles, the vegetables become mushy. So most of the times I avoid caramelization technique for vegetables. You can also choose to add caramelized onions if you want to have. Okay, we have the first whistle at 3 minutes 26 seconds. So you can also choose to add caramelized onions for a lovely flavor. You can choose to blend the onions and tomatoes after cooking, or you can choose to have it that way. Mostly we don't add any water in any sabjis. So this is the way I follow for a basic sabji. So whatever is at home, I follow this template personally and cook a sabji here. And even for peas, you don't have to defrost the peas or the paneer when you use it for an opos sabji. So make sure you use smaller vessels inside so that you are able to close the lid, and then there is space for the steam to generate. So you won't have any issues. If you use a very heavy vessel, it puts pressure on the tomatoes and onions. So it's been 4.5 minutes, so I'm waiting for my last whistle. So basically I read it somewhere that you don't cook with honey. It actually it's not good for health when you heat honey. So that's the reason why I'm going to add honey after I cook this while blending the onions and tomatoes. So here is the fourth whistle. So it's exactly, I'm switching it off. It's taking 4 minutes 57 seconds. So either 5 minutes off or whistles, whichever comes faster. The first, you please switch it on, switch it off accordingly. Now I'm going to release pressure here. Please always use a fork or a spoon for releasing pressure. Raise it in the opposite side of wherever you are standing. Please don't release pressure by showing the pressure cooker under water. It is dangerous. And you're going to waste a lot of water also. It's easier when you release pressure this way. Please make sure you raise the whistle on the opposite side, otherwise the hot steam comes onto your body. Now I've released pressure. Okay, I'm going to open the sabji here. And this is how it looks here. I'm going to remove the peas and paneer cups carefully. And I'm going to blend the sabji, blend the paste. It is very hot, so please make sure you use a tong like this to remove it. There'll be spice paste stuck to this vessels. Make sure you just remove it with a okay. So I'm going to just mix it well. Actually, I want to show you live. There has been a slight burning out here, but nothing to worry. The food is not burnt. There is no burnt smell in the food. The onions and tomatoes are caramelized well enough, so this is not burnt food. It is okay. Now I'm going to just blend this with 1 teaspoon of honey. So I'll just show you the blending now. I'm using a Philips 600 watts blender. Before this I had Prestige 200 watts blender. Personally that wasn't as powerful as a 600 watts blender. So you can choose to have any blender more than 500 watts for a nice blending capacity. I'm just going to blend it and I'll show you now. I'm not adding any water here. I'm going to grind it into a fine paste. You can choose to semi blend it. Now blend it into a fine paste. You can choose to add a quarter cup of water if you want to, not more than that, because it will dissolve the flavors out here. So the thing is blended, so I'm going to add 1 teaspoon of 1 teaspoon of honey here, just 1 teaspoon. Make sure you use good quality honey, because a lot of honey is adulterated. I've also heard that you're not supposed to give honey to infants. So when you have little babies at home, make sure they don't have any kind of allergies before adding this honey. So I've just added the honey here. I'm just going to I've blended it once again with honey. You can choose to add 2 or 3 tablespoons of fresh cream here if you like it. Otherwise, just leave it this way. Now I'm going to add back the paneer and the peas back to the gravy. So I'm adding the peas. Look at the color of the peas. Look at the color of the peas. Beautifully cooked. It's not mushy. I'm adding back the paneer also. It's not hard. So since I've not used the defrosted paneer and peas, there's little water remaining from the cup in the paneer, and that's given water to the gravy. So I've not added extra water to the sabji, and you can see a brilliant sabji ready in 5 minutes. That is cooking time. It's cooked in exactly 5 minutes. It's very simple, very tasty, and you can choose to follow the same template to make any sabji. You can choose to alter the spice levels, you can choose to alter the spices according to however you like it. And now you can see beautifully caramelized onions and tomatoes ground into a paste, and a restaurant style, a dhaba style sabji ready for you. I hope this thing was clear. I'll again show you the recipe now. Please serve it with hot rotis. If you can choose to add coriander leaves if you want. Otherwise, this is extremely tasty as it is. You can see the sabji. It's blended well. Beautiful gravy. So I'll show the recipe once again. This is the recipe. Please take a screenshot of it. I'll also post the recipe screenshot below this video. So in a 2 liter PC, add 2 tablespoon butter and 1 tablespoon water. Please don't reduce the quantity of butter because that gives a special taste. Add only 1 tablespoon of water, not more than that, because it will stop the caramelization of onions and tomatoes here when you add more water. And layer 2, I've added 1/2 cup of chopped onions on one side and 1 cup of chopped tomatoes on the other side. I've used all measuring cups to measure, and I've used the exact quantity here. And layer 3, I've added the spice powders, and along with it I've added 2 tablespoon cashew powder. So if you have any kind of cashew allergy, or if your kid has a cashew allergy, you can replace it with 2 tablespoon of almond powder. Above that, I kept 2 small vessels with 1/2 cup peas and paneer. You can choose to add paneer after you cook this. So adding paneer before is not a compulsion. You can add peas, only peas, when you cook this sabji. The other options are, you can choose to add potatoes and other vegetables in an inner vessel instead of mutter and paneer. And then I cooked it on high for 4 whistles or 5 minutes. If you let it beyond 5 minutes, there'll be a severe burning. So please make sure either it is 4 whistles or 5 minutes, whichever is earlier. We release pressure immediately, remove the cups carefully with a tong, and then finally blend it while adding 1 teaspoon honey. You can choose to add 2 tablespoons of fresh cream if you like it, or if you have it at home, it gives a very good taste. And the spice powders I've used for this recipe is 1 teaspoon opposed ginger garlic paste, 3/4 teaspoon each coriander powder and cumin powder, 1/2 teaspoon each salt, red chili powder and garam masala. You can choose to add degi mirch powder if you don't like the spiciness, and degi mirch powder gives a special red color. And finally, you add 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric powder and black pepper powder and 1 green chili. And then thank you for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Please enjoy this delicious dhaba style mughalai mutter paneer with your fulkas. Have a great weekend. Thank you once again.